I'm Murphy and welcome to Church. So today we're going to be talking about After. Like, I'm sure you guys have watched the movie, but I always talk about the one after one. I'm going to compare it with the book. So let's get into the video. So before we start, I just want to make a disclaimer that if you have not watched the movie, if you haven't read the novel, there are going to be spoilers. But at the same time, I feel like the movies to me is, I don't know which one I prefer actually, because I read the novel after I watched the movie. And why I even read the novel? Because most people that have read the novel first, they were like, they can't watch the movie, that the movie is going to spoil it for them and stuff like that. So I was like very confused, because for me, I like visuals and I like seeing visuals. I read novel normally also too, but I feel like visual is more amazing, because even when you're reading the novel, you're thinking and you're imagining what's happening. But when you're watching the movie, you're actually seeing what is happening. But people were like, they kind of watch the movie and everything. I'm like, okay, why don't them just read the novel and let me see what's about? And baby, I understood what I meant, because the novel is so, like, it's so detailed. It's so, like, you can just, even if you're imagining what's happening, because for me, I'm imagining hero, like, hidden, like, in the movie, and Tessa, that is just, I think, in the movie, when I'm reading the novel, not the characters, but I think the characters before, it was Harry. Because even when you're reading the novel, you can still see Harry in some place. He didn't put Aiden in there. So I feel like that was Harry. Maybe Harry Styles, I don't know. Maybe that's one of the reasons why some people don't want to watch the movies. But the female, I don't know who she is for the female, but me, I imagine the design of the movie to watch the movie. Anyways, so when I was reading the novel anyway. But the novel is just, there's some things that they omitted in the movie, like they didn't put in the movie when, obviously, like, since just they had to put it in, like, so it's, the movie is like 1 hour, some, like, for something minutes, it's not 2 hours, so I feel like they had to put, and the novel is 99 chapters, for so they had to compress everything into one, like, 1 hour and 2 minutes. I understand that part, but there's some part that's just, like, very, very important that I should have just left in. And some dramatic scenes and some characters that we saw more of them, like Noah now, novel, we saw more of him, it came around more. And this one, what's this guy named? London more. Our relationship with Tessa, like, we had more details. She was, even before the wedding, she was close to Tessa and everything. Even Hayden, because I was his dad, not like fully forgiveness, but the way he was already talking to his dad and everything. Even with the stepmom. And even London, we saw more of London, we saw more of his girlfriend also, some of them. Even Steph, and in the novel, Steph is making more sense to me, because she actually looked out for Tessa more in the novel, but in the movie, we didn't really even see her in the movie, she didn't really look out for Tess. But in the novel, she did. And she was a lesbian in the movie, but she was straight, at least now, you know, in the novel, because she had a boyfriend. And boyfriend, it was part of hidden group of friends. And again, we knew Jace from the beginning in the novel, but in the novel, we knew around like the ending, and it was kind of person that had his own group, like it was in this house kind of thing. So it was very different, and it's kind of weird. Even when I first was reading the novel, I was like, where's Jace? And this song, Zed, so with some of Zed, because Jace almost dated him and everything, they almost dated him. Yeah, in the novel, he had like a connection, should I put it like that, novel, and Hayden was very toxic in the novel, but it was even more toxic, like at the beginning it was just too much, like at the beginning when they actually had a very actual conversation in my test, you already cried in the novel, but I'm like, but later, I think when they started dating, like actual dates, because they were together with Flair at first, before they actually defined the relationship, was kind of like, it was changing. But at the same time, it was like that nature was still there, but was changing at least. We could see the changing. I mean, we could see the changes there. But at the same time, it was like still there. You can still tell that toxic trait is still in my anger issue. And also, it's actually very nice to hear our thoughts. Like, you know, in the novels, they write our thoughts and everything is in details. But when you're reading the novel, the thought is not, like, very detailed. It's like, they are not giving us our thoughts. They're just showing you the expression. It's sure, don't let me get wrong. They actually portray the own characters very well. Like, the intensity, the way they used to do. But in the novels, like, when she's describing the intestine, you're just imagining everything in your head. It's like more, wow. And there's even more details for you to like read and everything, for you to understand the characters more better. And you have first kiss in the novel, in the movie. The first kiss in the point of the see. Anyway, where he took her, like each other is hiding spot to think and everything about where he took her. But in the novel, their first kiss was in his room. You know, when in the movie, there was the first party she went to. Like, you know, she went for a party. Like, when they did truth and dare, but almost they dared her to kiss Aiden, but she didn't kiss him. Then she went to his room that they almost kissed, but didn't kiss. But that place, the scene was actually different because even the first party that Steph invited her, she didn't go. In the novel, she actually went a first time. And she went to his room. Then she slept over, but she slept in another room because Aiden was actually in the fraternity. And she slept in another place. Then she almost got raped. Then she went to Aiden's room. That's when she kissed him. She was actually kissed him, not the other way around. So then later, she knew Aiden has a problem. So she had said someone, then she started crying. That was the first time she actually had a conversation with Aiden. Except for when she was in her room, when she saw that mirror, she was dressed in also in the novel. But the novel one is more longer version. Anyway, so that was when the first kiss, not the pound. Then it was later in the novel, they went to pound, like, and they argued in class, like, for when they were doing that Pride and Prejudice. Then the arguments were very intense. They even went outside the dog, that's when Nina took her to the pond. Their connection and relationship went more than kissing, but not to, like, to the extreme, like not to the end, you should understand what I mean. But it did go more than kissing there. And also, a breakup with Noah was very dramatic. In the movie, it was not very dramatic, it was just like a very slow thing where Ellie started drinking, then she went there, then Noah came out. My novel, it was very dramatic. Like, I'm saying, and if you get novel, like, I was like, why did you just put this in there? Like, but I guess there was a shot in the movie. And seriously, their fights in the movies are more intense than, you know. And in the movie, so they hardly really fought, except from the beginning. When they started dating, like, they just started dating like that. They didn't just start dating just like that. This thing, because she said he could not date, then they were fooling around. She even made experience before they even started dating. Polita was not like, okay, let me start it. And he didn't even tell his friends. And she was like, he was embarrassed, just like in the novel too. Like, when they made him a box, and she was like, embarrassed to see her stuff. But that was at the beginning when he first went to the pond. But this one is different anyway. And the fight are more intense. Like, they fight like almost every day. Like, every time. Like, if they don't fight, their fights can be 24 hours. That's the highest. Fight in the novel, actually. But the movie, you see them sweet moment, everything, you know, they're just keeping everything together there and they had the fight and everything. But in the novel, the fight was very more interesting. There's even one time it was in his dad house, because he stayed more in that house in actually in the novel than in the fraternity. That even broke his computer and everything, she even helped him. And even with Noah, like, you know, at the beginning, Noah finally just left. But later, this one, he forgave her, then they continued dating, then later they broke up again. That was when the dramatic breakup now happened. But I won't lie, I understand why people don't want to watch the movie after reading the novel, because I watched the movie before I read the novel, and I was still feeling the novel more than the movie. Oh, so I actually like the novel more than the movie then. Which is like, it takes more time, because except you are a very fast reader. And also, when Noah came to our school in the movie, that they went for a bonfire, that they played this sucking game. The thing is that in the novel, that didn't happen. So it was actually sucking game with other people, like Jesus, I told about, like, get out with his friends group. That's when they played the sucking game. That Aiden almost beat one of them up. That beat one of them up, not even almost, yeah. The other one of them, but this time it was Jesus that he beat in the movie, but it was not Jesus that he beat in the novel. It was under friend of his, and so that sort of game was just like Andy, like in the, you know, like the beginning, and she was not with Noah, that she was with Aiden. More so the fact that was way more dramatic in the movie, way more dramatic. And when her mom cut her off, like in the movie and everything, she's cut her off in the novel, but the novel was more, she like, was more extended, more prolonged. And again, this guy, in the movie, he just took her to one of his dad's friends' place to stay. But this one, they actually got the house together, like an apartment together. Apparently, Noah is very. Apparently, Aiden is very rich. They actually got an apartment together, and even before, and in the movie too, she got a job after she fought Noah. I mean, she found out bed and everything, and so it was the father that first told about job during his wedding. But this one, it was Aiden that first told her in the novel, and she got a job way before they even had any issue. She was already working there. And then from there, then she got apartment together. Like, the apartment was on their both of their name, not just like his dad, Fred, or anything like that. It was actually their own space where they bought furniture and they bought everything inside. And also, when they first had sex, they had sex after a father's wedding, right? After his dad's wedding. But this one was actually before they even moved in together. They had sex and everything. And that was when her mom came, that she was like, her mom was like, girl, we'll leave you when you have sex. And she was like, guess what? It's inside my pants already and it's with me. Then even her mom came to the apartment that they moved in together. So they started fighting and everything. He didn't even threaten her because she slapped Tessa. The film is, you know, way more intense than the movie. Let's just put it like that. Because it's longer. And the action is more there than in the movie. The movie is more like a softer version. Let's put it like that. While the novel is like the hardcore version. Like everything you want is there. Something like that. And when Aiden confessed his love in the movie, like, it was when they were having in battle. I put a love at the back. Something's different. It was when they were fighting in his dad's house. Like, actually do that in the movie, because they're almost always in that house. That's where they most spend their time, because she's close to London mom and she's kind of close to that somehow. And the story about his mom being raped, he didn't told her during his dad's wedding, but this one he told her before they went for the wedding. And the wedding was around like the ending of this novel, not that like at the beginning, sort of. Like, it's around, like, the ending, like, maybe two chapters to the ending of the novel. And then, that was when, this marriage was more than a message during the novel, that messaged him that she saw. So, it was Jace that messaged him that she saw. And the way they ended the novel is from when they ended the movie. No, the novel was in a cliffhanger. We did not know what was going to happen and everything. The novel, they told us there was a bit. It was not a cliffhanger, but we knew about the bed and everything, but in this part one of the novel, we didn't know anything about it. She just got to Bob and she saw the first again, and she just wished she never came. That was where they ended the novel. But while in the movie, they told us the best, then she applied for the job, then we saw Aiden writing the report and everything. But novel, all these things happened in the novel. So they had some things in the novel, in the movie, there are some things in the movie that they removed from that they didn't put in the novel. And there's some things they added in the movie. But there's some things they added in the movie that didn't have in the novel. Yeah. But I think from what I've been saying this morning, you can tell why I like the novel more. So you guys try the novel out. And if you guys like this video, you should tell me I'll put it to part two of half that. And if there's another movie and novel you want me to try out, you should also tell me that too. So you guys, that'll be all for today. You guys should not forget to comment what you guys think. If you have watched both, do you like more? If you have not watched, are you going to read the novel or try to read it? And if you have read the novel, are you going to watch the novel? Guys, tell me in the comment down below. So that'll be all for you today, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.